Okay, so in this video, I'm gonna be showing you how to add ice or snow to a surface of any object. I'm gonna use a car as the object, but you can also use any other object. If you haven't done it already, you first have to add a new material to your object. In my case, it's this black car paint, and now we want to mix this black color with a snow or ice material. For that, I've already added this mixed shader node, so we can now duplicate the principled BSDF shader and plug it into the second shader input of the mixed shader node. And here we can, with the node wrangler add-on activated, press Ctrl, Shift and T and open our snow or ice material. I'm using this snow material from Ambient CG, so you can also download it if you want. Now the snow material is on the whole car, but we don't want it to be everywhere, but only on the upper surfaces, so on top of the car. To do so, we need a separate XYZ node, which we can use as our factor in the mix shader. And because we want the ice only to be on top of the car, we have to use the C output and plug it into the factor. Now you see it does not work really well, and that's because we need another node, and that's the geometry node. And here we have to plug the normal into the vector, and now you can see that the snow material is only on top of the car. This does not look really realistic, and that's why we have to add some noise with a noise texture. And now we have to mix both the noise texture and the separate XYZ texture together, so we have the ice only on top of the car, but also with some noise. We are gonna use a mix node for that, but we have to change it from float to color and from mix to multiply. Now we can plug the C value in the B value and the factor of the noise texture into the A value of the mix node. And the mix node we can use as our factor in the mix shader now. If we now Control, Shift and click the noise texture, we can see what exactly it does. And right now it's a little bit stretched along the y-axis, and that's why we are gonna press Control T again with the node wrangler add-on activated. And now we have here a texture coordinate and a mapping node, and here we can adjust the y-scale so the noise texture is not stretched anymore. Now we can also adjust these values of the noise texture to achieve a good looking ice. These are the values I use, you can just copy them. In rendered mode it looks like this right now, and for the final touch I'm gonna add a color ramp and put it between the multiply node and the mix shader. And here we can now adjust the contrast between white and black of the noise texture. This does look really cool. If you want, you can additionally plug this color output of the color ramp into the height of a displacement node to add some displacement and realism to the whole ice. That's it. I hope you liked the video. If so, feel free to like and subscribe. Until next time, bye.